Hello friends, we'll be discussing the concept of introduction to the theory of consumer behavior here. Now, while we are discussing the theory of consumer behavior, this introduction will give you a brief idea about how a consumer behaves when there is a price change, when there is a price drop, or the terms of demand and supply that we have referred to earlier. Now, let us understand few details with the introduction part of it. Let us give some brief description on this. Now, the theory of consumer behavior deals with the problems of constrained optimization that a consumer faces while making choices among various goods and services. The theory states that the consumer behavior, it deals with the problems of constrained optimization. We have constrained optimization here. The problem is constrained optimization that a consumer faces while making choices amongst various goods and services. So if you have different options, you get a little confused. You have certain restrictions on to the price or other features. So if you're buying a car, basically you might have a certain budget while buying a car, as if you're termed in a normal economy. If you're a rich person, of course you will buy the car that you want to, but if you're a middle class person, you will still have certain constraints on you, whereby within this budget you want so many features coming up in between. So whichever cars offers you that, you will opt for that car. Now the next thing comes up, whether the look of that car is plausible, or rather is a plausible contract, or rather when we can talk about whether this specific look of the car is as per the requirement that you are looking for. And if the look is fine and if it offers all the feature, then of course you will go for the same thing. But if at all the look is not fine but it is offering all the feature, then you will think whether you need to buy this car or not, whether you want to go ahead with this car or not. And if you're still feeling fine, you'll go ahead with that car. So these are the possible constraints that you have while going for anything related to these topics. Now let us go on to the next line of this. In other words, the theory is concerned with the behavior of consumers faced with resource constraint in the market while demanding goods and services to alter, maximize satisfaction. Consumer demand goods as they provide utility to him. Now, basically all these things. So in a market, you demand certain goods, but you have certain restrictions, you have certain constraints which you need to follow, which you need to figure out. But in case if those constraints are not there, then you can demand as per your requirement because there are no certain constraints like this. Now, utility is nothing but the satisfaction derived from the consumption of goods and services. So utility is nothing. Whatever you utilize, you get certain satisfaction from the consumption of those goods and services. So if you are tired completely, you go for a spa, you go for drinks, you go for somewhere outing, you go for a small vacation. Now, whatever services you have enjoyed here, whatever things that you have enjoyed here, it gives you certain kind of satisfaction. That is known as money's worth. Now this happens, or rather when this happens, you gain certain satisfaction, and that satisfaction leads to utility of all these resources. So for example, if you have bought a car, you will utilize that car to go from one place to another at your own convenience. You don't have to rely upon certain public transports. You don't have to rely upon booking tickets. You don't have to wait for all these tickets to be confirmed to go to these places. You can travel absolutely in your car, and that will be at your convenience. So hence you are being utilized, or rather you are utilizing that specific product here. Now the concept of utility of a good or service is central to understand the consumer behavior because it influences the demand and price of goods and services. Now whatever utility we are discussing about, that utility is central in nature, and that further goes ahead and describes about what kind of demand and what kind of price will it influence as per the market conditions. So whatever conditions prevailing in the market, according to that, if the consumer is demanding a specific good, maybe any kind of good it may be. Now whatever good is being demanded here, if that good is taken into consideration, now the price for that specific goods or service will depend on what kind of demand it has in the market. Now you have to consider that part first. The different theories of consumer behavior assumes that consumer would always strive to maximize his utility. There are different theories whereby the consumer behavior is analyzed on this, and here they are stating that consumer will always strive to maximize the utility. Whatever goods you have, take an example of the toothpaste. whenever there is a last drop in that toothpaste or last fraction of paste that is remaining in the toothpaste, you push it up, you actually squeeze that toothpaste. Why? Is because you want to utilize the complete toothpaste because you have provided money for that. Hence, that kind of thing, make sure that you utilize the product or the goods or the service to the maximum utility here, or maximum optimization. Being a rational individual, consumers want to maximize his satisfaction given the income constraint. Now, there is a given income constraint. That means you already have a restricted income here. You don't have money flowing in like 11 lakhs or 10 lakhs a month. Now, if you have a certain income restraint or rather constraint here, there are certain restrictions that you already have. Then in that case, you need to understand few things. First, that in such income, you need to buy or rather you need to do certain budgeting. That is one for thing sure. Or rather, with all these things, with all this budgeting, whatever things you produce or whatever things you go ahead and buy, you want maximum utilization on that part. This is what you need to understand. Therefore, it can be said that the theories of consumer behavior are concerned with the question as to how a consumer should spend his limited income on different combination of goods and services so that he may get maximum utility. Therefore, it has to be said that whatever amount you receive, or rather whatever things are concerned in this scenario, whatever things you're buying, goods, services, whatever it may be, then in that case, you need to make sure that whatever things are being brought up, you need to utilize it to the maximum efficiency, maximum optimization. This is what you need to make sure, because you have limited income to spend, and with this limited income, you need a maximum output on that part. This is what you need to think of. So this behavior, or rather this is the introduction to the behavior of consumer, or rather whatever demands and whatever services are being made available at a restricted income. So here three factors are supposed to be considered: price of the product, the demand for the product, utility, and utility is referred to the satisfaction. Now, with all these three constraints being there, there is fourth additional constraint that has to be taken into consideration with all these three, is the income constraint. So whatever income you have will be restricted. You'll have to do budgeting, and based on that, how a consumer behaves, or rather what is the consumer behavior to maximize the profit in that scenario, is what you need to understand. So this is all what you can talk about when it comes to introduction to the theory of consumer behavior. So that's all that we have for this video. Thank you.